Good morning, everybody. Thank you very much for participating in my lecture today. As I was introduced, the lecture of my title of lecture, proceeding predicting the maximum compressive strengths of geopolymers, considering chemical compositions of binders. Geopolymers are composite hard materials made by mixing solid binders such as fly ash and slag and liquid activators such as sodium hydroxide NaOH and sodium silicate. Fly ash steel making slags categorized in slag 1 and garbage melting furnace slags categorized in slag 2, industrial byproducts and can be used to create geopolymers in a process that emits less carbon dioxide CO2 than in the cement making process. This reduction in CO2 emission is important because CO2 is one of the substances known to contribute to global warming. In the future, further uses of these fly ash and slags must be explored for geopolymer work. When designing the geopolymer works, it is essential to predict the maximum compressive strength of geopolymers QU max using chemical composition of binders only. This lecture introduces an idea to predict the QU max by combining three main chemical compositions, silicon dioxide, aluminum oxide, and calcium oxide in binders. Production of geopolymers, preparation of binders, the particle size of binders, D50 is smaller than 0.116 millimeter, according to Koumoto. The particle size is smaller is better. Making of geopolymer samples, the compressive strength QU is generally considered as a function of W and eta as QU equal F W eta, where W ratio of solution NaOH and sodium silicate to solid binder such as fly ash or slag by weight, eta ratio of NaOH to sodium silicate by weight. According to Koumoto, the W becomes the optimum value, W opt being equal to 0.4 to yield the QU max. In the research, eta values were varied in the range of 0 to 1. Table 1 shows chemical compositions of tested geopolymer materials. In the table, 27 kinds of geopolymer samples are listed, and they are classified the 10 categories of geopolymer materials. yellow colors is raw materials offered, and the others are mixed materials. This samples made from mixing each other is raw materials. Figure 1.1 shows QU is the relationship for geopolymers for fly ash, slag 1, slag 2, and acid proof cement, raw materials offered. From figure, the QU eta relation is becomes a curve having the peak value like this. And this peak occurs at a certain eta values. The peak is peak value of QU defined as QU max, and the value of eta yielding QU max is defined as eta of. This figure 1.2 A and B shows also the relationship between QU and eta. All were geopolymer samples of mixed binders. Similar to figure 1.1, figure 1.2 A and B QU eta relation also becomes curve having peak value at certain eta value. These peak values and eta values are defined as QU max and eta of. Table 2 is a compression test result of geopolymer samples listed in this table. QU max and eta opt, and dou T and delta V over V is this one is density, and this one is volume shrinkage limit of geopolymer samples yielded QU max. Figure 2 shows correlation between eta opt and CCAS. CAS is the ratio of CaO over Al2O3 plus SiO2. The relationship between eta opt and CAS is well correlated and expressed by this equation with the high correlation coefficient of R equal 0.932. This equation is used to calculate the eta opt from CCAS of binders to effectively produce high compressive strengths of geopolymer. predicting the maximum compressive strength of geopolymers. Now, predicting the QU max of geopolymers based on three main chemical compositions, SiO2, Al2O3, and CaO. The following exponential expression was introduced as by equation one, QU max equal A exponential B x, where A and B are constants, are chi. Chi is expressed as the SiO2 power of alpha multiplied Al2O3 power of beta multiplied CaO power of gamma. The most appropriate combination of the power numbers alpha and beta are determined while gamma being assumed to be one. When the above equations are obtained by least square method with the highest correlation coefficients R. The figure 3 shows the grids of alpha beta axis to calculate the correlation between QU max and chi on every point shown as solid circles. Some examples of calculated results are introduced as follows. Figure 4. The correlation between QU max and X in the case of alpha equal beta equal gamma equal 1 is shown in this figure. In this case is correlation factor R is 0.779, rather low value. Figure 5.1 shows QU max versus chi for alpha equal 0.5 and beta is equal 0.6, 0.7, 0.8. In this case, is R varies from 0.916 to 916. Fig 5.2 shows QU max versus chi for alpha equal 0.6 and beta is from 0.67 to 0.8. In this case, the R value is varies from 0.909 this case and until 0.918 this case. Similarly, fig 5.3 QU max versus chi for alpha equals 0.7 and beta as from 0.6 0.8. In this case, R varies from 0.902 to 0.995. Peak 6 shows a chart for determining the most appropriate combination of alpha and beta from the calculation. In figure 6, the open circle means the R is smaller than 0.9, and triangle R in between 0.9 to 0.915. The square means R is larger than 0.95 and smaller than 0.95. And the rhombus means R is larger than 0.917. And the red solid circle means the highest R equal 0.918, then alpha is 0.61, beta equal 0.68 obtained. By trial and error method, the most appropriate combination was determined as alpha equal 0.61 and beta equal 0.68, while gamma being assumed to be 1.0. And A is 17.42 and B equal 9.587 multiplied 10 power of minus 4. The QU max equation is expressed with a high correlation coefficient R equal 0.918 as by equation 2. QE max equal 17.42 exponential 9.587 multiplied 10 power of minus 4 chi, and where chi is equal SiO2 power of 0.61 multiplied Al2O3 power of 0.68 multiplied CaO 1.0. Figure 7 is relationship between QU max and this chi 5. And this is a obtained test data is plotted, and this solid line is the equation 2 was drawn. And figure 8 shows a comparison of tested and predicted values of QU max. From this figure, all data are plotted along the 45 degree line, solid line, and the predicted values of QU max in the error range of plus 25 minus 25% line of QU max. Now, the conclusions. The research results are summarized as, first, the NOPT is a opt a liquid weight ratio between NaOH and sodium silicate is well correlated with the factor CAS as this equation. This equation is used to calculate the eta opt value from the CAS value of binders to effectively produce high compressive strength geopolymers. Two, the relationship between QU max and SiO2 power alpha multiply L2O3 power of beta and CaO power of gamma shows the highest correlation factor equal 0.918 for alpha equals 0.61 and beta equals 0.68, while gamma being assumed to be 1.0 and expressed by the exponential equation as QE max equal 17.42 exponential 9.587 multiply 10 power of minus 4 chi, where chi is expressed as this. The predicted values Q max in the error range of plus minus 25% of the tested values QU max. That's all. Thank you very much for the kind attention.